Today we are learning about cost sheet. What is cost sheet? Why you need to prepare that one? Okay, cost sheet we are preparing to fix the price of manufactured item. So in this you will take under consideration of all the items to manufacture an item or to manufacture a product. Okay, from the purchase of raw materials to till at the time of sale, whatever is required, everything you have to take under consideration. Okay, so now let us see how to prepare cost sheet. Here you are preparing cost sheet in the books of Neeraja. So Neeraja Limited started some manufacturing of some items. So what they have done, let us see. So here even the purchase of raw material, from there you will be starting. Okay, and what are the factory overheads? So that means while manufacturing, what are the expenses you made, or at the time of admin, what kind of expenses, what are the selling and distribution, everything you have to take under consideration. The question is given in the description box. Please check the description for the question. Okay, so now first let's check it out about what are the opening raw materials. Is there any opening raw materials?
Yes, it's there.
Yes, okay, fine. First let me write down opening stock of raw materials. How much?
Rupees 10,000.
During the year, is there any purchases?
Yes, it's there.
Add purchases. How much?
50,000.
50. So total 60,000. Is there any expenses they made to purchase the item, like carriage imports or taxes, anything like that?
Yes, ma'am, it's there.
Okay, what is that?
Expense on purchase. Rupees 2,000.
Add expense on purchase. How much?
Rupees 2,000.
2,000. So total you will get 62,000. Is there any closing?
Yes, ma'am.
What is closing stock of raw materials? Less closing stock of raw materials. How much?
12,000.
12,000. Now what is the total materials consumed? 50,000.
Yes. Ma'am.
Huh?
Why are we taking this purchase of raw material in the starting and closing it in the starting itself? Why not in the end?
Okay, why we are adding the opening stock and why we are subtracting the closing stock? Is that the doubt clearly? Okay, fine. Now here, I am manufactured few items. Only for that I have to prepare the cost sheet. Okay, not for the whole. And manufacturing mostly not for only 1000 units or not only for the 50 units. It is a continuous process. Once some of the goods you will manufacture, and again once manufacturing is done, again you will continue with the same thing. Right? So here I need to find out manufacturing of only these many items. So when I have started manufacturing, what is the stock I am having with me? That is opening stock. I think I am having in my hand 20 units. In my hand I am having 20 units. In the meanwhile, I have purchased 300 units. In the meanwhile, I have purchased 300 units. The total how many units I am having with me? 320. Right? Now, I completed the total manufacturing process. I completed everything. After completion of everything, it's not compulsory like only dot, only this much material only I have to use. It may go more or it may go less. Right? So, after completion of everything, in my hand, 10 units are there. So, total how many units I have used to manufacture these products? Total 310. Opening stock 20. And I have purchased 300. Total 320 units are there in my hand. After manufacturing, in my hand only 10 units left. That means I used the materials only 310 to manufacture the product. Got it? So that is the way you will be doing. That is the reason you will be adding opening stock and closing subtracted. Got it? Always, wherever it comes, you have to follow the same thing. Add the opening stocks, subtract the closing stocks. So, next, is there any productive wages or chargeable wages?
Yes, productive wages.
Productive wages. How much?
30,000.
Next, you have chargeable expenses. If you have chargeable expenses, take. If it is not there, nil. Is there any chargeable expenses?
No.
No. Then, nil. What is the total? 80,000. This is called prime cost. This is called prime cost. To this add factory overheads. This is also called works overheads. Factory overheads are works overheads. Okay, is there any factory overheads?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, tell me.
Depreciation on plant and machinery.
Depreciation on plant and machinery.
Rupees 8000.
If it is furniture, it will come in the office expenses. It is plant and machinery, will be used in the factories only. So we are showing in the factory overheads. Next.
Factory cleaning charges.
How much?
Rupees 1500.
Next.
Works manager salary. Rupees 6000.
Next.
Power and fuel, rupees 4000.
Next.
Office drawing and salary.
How much?
Rupees 4000. Factory expenses. Rupees 2000.
What is the total of factory overheads?
25,500.
Is there any opening stock or work in progress?
Yes, ma'am.
Opening stock or work in progress. How much?
Rupees 9000.
Then you will get balance of 34,500. Is there any closing stock?
Yes, ma'am.
Closing stock of work in progress. How much?
Rupees 6000.
Rupees 6000. Then what is the balance? 20,500, is it? 34,500 minus 6,000.
Yes, ma'am.
28,500. Less sale of scrap. Is there any scrap?
Yes, ma'am.
How much?
1,000.
Now what is the total? 27,500. Now add these two, 27,500 plus 80,000. That is what? Works cost. How much you will get? 80,000 plus 27,500. 1,07,500. Right? 1,07,500. To this add administrative overheads. Is there any administrative overheads given in the question?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Tell me.
Office rent.
How much?
7,000.
Next.
Director's fee. 7,500. Staff salary.
How much?
15,000.
Any more?
That's it. Total.
That's all. So the total is?
29,500.
Any opening and closing stock of finished goods?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Add the opening stock of finished goods. How much?
Rupees 4,000.
Now the total is 33,500. Less closing stock of finished goods. How much?
3,000.
Then you will get 30,500. Add these two. How much you will get? What is the total? 1,38,000. To this add selling and distribution overheads. Is there any selling and distribution overheads?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. What are those? Carriage, outwards, how much?
Rupees 5,000.
Any more?
Advertisement. 3,000.
Next.
Salesman salary. 17,000.
Any more?
That's it.
That's all. So the total selling and distribution overheads are 25,000. Total selling and distribution overheads are 25,000. Now do the total of these two. That is called total cost. What is the total cost?
1,63,000.
To this, we will add our profit and then we will fix the selling price. In the question, they may give you profit or they may give you sales. Okay? What is the sales given in the question? Sales they give or profit?
Sales.
What is sales?
2,10,000.
2,10,000. Your selling price is 2,10,000 and your manufacturing price is 1,63,000. Now what will be the profit? To find out the profit, you have to subtract these two. 2,10,000 minus 1,63,000. How much you will get?
47,000.
Okay, so this is the way to prepare the cost sheet and find out the profit. Mainly what you should see, check the question. You should understand which expense will come under which head. Okay, will it come under factory overheads or administrative overheads or selling and distribution? If you know that, it will be very easy for you to do. Thank you for watching, all of you. If you like, please put a comment. Thank you.